Andrea, that was the Cadbury,
yes.
Which shut down, yeah?
Which shut down, yes, Cadbury, and it shut down. I think it was built, bought by an Australian company.
Is that right?
But it was like this.
The roller jaffers down the street.
Oh, okay. Let's have a look.
at the top. We're nearly there.
Let's go. Well, there are a few words for your experience.
Bloody steep.
It's a steep,
yeah. Not exaggerating. It's quite, oh look, it's beautiful flowers. It was very steep. Got heart attack material, Mum. I'm glad you didn't come. No, I tell you what,
you sit on it, see just out here on the right hand side, all these big burn marks down here? You buy an old piece of furniture, you put them on your deck and your front lawn, but when you get sick of that idea, you set them on fire in the middle of the road. And you might even see some old remains of couches. Now, it's not allowed, of course, but it's really hard to prove, so the police and the fire brigade will turn up and then they'll say, so what's happened here? And they'll go, oh.
Innocent.
Well, it looks quite tidy because, yes, that one there's got a lot of couches ready for next year. It looks quite tidy because the students are all away and this is the time that the landlords come in, clean up. This street here has literally just been retail sealed and the other one will be done before they arrive back at the end of February. And then it all starts all over again. Now, the other culture that we have is that they name their flats. Quite often those flats are named for generations. And you may have passed some already that we have the jungle, we have the fridge, and next door we've got the fridgettes. We've got the pink pussy, the greasy beaver, birdcage, Barbie's house, and the list goes on and on. Now, before we were talking about the need for new student accommodation, it's because there's parties that are going on down here are becoming more and more out of control. Just before Christmas, you may have heard that we had a party down here where it was attended by 600 students, and that it got out of control and they stampled a young girl to death. And so by building the student accommodation, they feel that the university can have more control over it. As we speak, the university are buying quite a lot of the properties closer and closer to the university up. So, honestly, in a room and in any one of these flats, you'd be looking around about $160 for a room. Now, the university students, are actually buying a lot of the homes and turning them into clinics and office spaces, just trying to really cut down on the university students being able to have that party atmosphere. And of course, the entrance to the Otago University just here on the left-hand side. This is where when they get their capping done, they're all getting their photos taken against that sign. All those lime scooters are a pain in the bum.
Yeah, they are everywhere.
It's just like...
Why would they dump them?
They just dump them everywhere, don't they?
No.
Let's go back in time though. So 1848, Dunedin's founded. Of course, on the right-hand side, we've got our High Court. It still remains us to this very day. And just right beside it, we've got the old jail. We've got a big brand new one down in Milton, about 55 kilometres away. We call it the Milton Hilton. Now, this one here is totally worth taking yourselves to as well. It's free. Toy 2, the Early Settlers Museum. Now, Toy 2 is, don't think old, boring, stodgy. Think modern, interactive, fun, retro. It's really, really neat. It takes up the entire block. They've got an amazing transport section in there with the old caravans. They've got all Alison Hulse old cooking things and dishwashers. It's really, really, really cool. And it's completely free. I would say that allow yourself a good hour in there though, and you won't regret it. So walk yourselves down there. And of course the Anzac Cenotaph, something that you Kiwis will be very familiar with. Every single day we have to have a big vacuum cleaner like dredge that vacuums the whole entire harbour basin or channel right out to Tairoa Head. On a daily basis she would take the equivalent of about 35 truck and trailer loads of silt out daily to
it goes
wet. Yeah. And so as the tide goes in and out, the harbour basin literally turns into mud flats. So you can walk almost all the way across our harbour at low tide.
Without sinking.
Without going past this sort of deck. Yeah. Oh, wow. Coming back to the centre of town itself, you see that we've got a big band of bush that cuts in the middle there. That's the town belt. Back in those early days, everything on this side would have been the city and everything on that side would have been the farmland, so that was their boundary. Now the big hill in the distance is actually called Saddle Hill. It's shaped like a saddle if you were out at sea. 1770 Captain Cook named it that after sailing past, and it's one of only three places in the region that retains an original name. If you look about 12 o'clock, there's a big black building with two white stripes. Slightly to the right of that is a small clump of trees. That's the octagon, that's where I picked you up from. So it gives you an idea of the distance that we're travelling. I know it's freezing and I won't keep you out here too much, but if you want to throw some cameras out there, and I'll get a photo down here.
Yeah, it's fresh.
Carl, will you do some on that side?
So to speak.
So we're just moving into the old precinct of Dunedin. You'll remember me saying up at the lookout that the water used to come a lot closer, so they would have parked their sailing ships a lot closer as well. And they would have wandered into this area here called the Exchange, and this is where they had their old banks. And as we turn this corner, you'll see the old banks on the right-hand side. But just so you know, the city used to be really divided in the 1800s. So down here, they would have had their banks and their shops and their homes. Then there was a big hill, and then there was the Octagon area, or what was going to become the Octagon area. Now, back in those days, they had their rubbish dumps and their offal pits up this end, in the octagon end, and every time the wives said, "Hey honey, go and put the rubbish out," he would have had to lug the rubbish over this huge hill. And much to his disgust, someone had a bright idea one day that let's just get rid of the hill. So they took 40 feet of rock off the top of the hill and really opened the city up. That's when the Presbyterians decided, like, look at that, we're going to put our big fancy first church right in the middle now, because we're right in the middle of the city. Except, irony would have it that they're actually not in the middle of the city now, and the people that are were the religions that they actually pushed to the most unwanted areas, like the Catholics and the Anglicans. And it just so happens that the Anglicans are right in the octagon now and not the Presbyterians. And of course we're just travelling up what would have been Bell Hill, and remembering that they took 40 feet of rock off this hill. Now, if you're interested in going to see the first Presbyterian church, it's just at this next set of lights as we pass through, turn to your right. Again, Robert Lawson's work, that Australian architect, very Gothic. You may have seen the statue of Robbie Burns.
Yes.
Now, of course, he never set foot in Dunedin at all. It was his nephew, Reverend Thomas Burns, that was one of our early city forefathers. Robbie was actually really well known for, of course, writing of Auld Lang Syne. Hey, just take a look out to the right there. You'll see a tribal museum just there. Definitely, it's $5. Go and have a quick look at it. We're just going to shoot through this light. Go and have a quick look at it, because it's a guy that actually doesn't normally put it here. He's a Dunedinite. He's travelled the world and actually made this amazing collection of tribal warriors from all over the world, bringing back their original bits and pieces. And he is truly it's $5 to get in, and it's pretty impressive. So if you want to go and have a look at that, please do. Hey, it's been a pleasure having you aboard.
What are you, man?
What's up?
I'm a legend as well.
Are you now?
We're two legends. We're legendary.
I heard.
Back out, then they pull us out, or I've got you. I'm not going to let you go.
Your back.
And you walk out.
Oh, yes. Sitting there reading the book. So when was the last time you arrived in Wellington? Oh, shit. No, I'm not even picking theory.
So, a few words.
1964.
1964.
1964 was the last time she arrived by ship.
Yeah. And did Mommy tell you that she lost the glasses?
No.
But yes. She found them.
When? Oh, I thought you'd lost them over the
no,
ship.
No, she found them.
Oh. Where were they?
Well, I think an ask at the
reception.
Yes.
In Emily's very tidy cabin.
Yeah.
That was good timing.
I just finished my book. What was good timing? She just finished
her book. Oh, okay.
So 38 feet. Okay, so 7. Okay.
Thank you. Andrea.
I'm gonna ring my mother.
I'd love to go and do Dunedin and do that Tairi Railway. Thank you.
Is it pirate? I don't know.
You should see KJ, the building with the kind of brown stripe.
Hi, I'm good, how are you? Yeah, so KJ from here.
Really?
I keep seeing KJ, wherever we go, I keep seeing it.
What is KJ anyway?
Just doing it. You have no privacy if you looked at it.
Thank you.
Hi there.
Hello, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Standing room only over there, Mama.
Thank you.
over there.
What's his name over there?
Can you see Neville Smith?
What's that?
Can you see Neville Smith?
No, but who wouldn't be here? What would it be here?
David.
And still going. I do a few words, please.
We're just watching. We're going to be going in just under an hour's time ourselves.
Yes.
We're watching this boat coming. We're quite intrigued.
Yes. Whereabouts are we?
We're on deck 13 forward.
What city?
Aft, Napier. There's Bluff Hill, the Lookout Hill. A number of times we've stood up there and watched a ship. And now we're on a ship. And this morning we were watching the logs being loaded. We're not loading anything. Far off,
what next.